My patients think Viagra is only about erections. That's a big problem because this class of drugs is capable of so much more. For many, it is hard to believe that a drug could have two or more totally different benefits. But what if I told you these pills could also affect your bladder and your pelvic floor? I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, one of the most copied urologists on YouTube. Urology is underestimated big time. It may be a small field, but it defines quality of life more than any other field in medicine, because sooner or later, everybody's gonna be affected. So here's my mission, to empower men to live 10 years longer. Subscribe to my channel if you don't want to miss out on future content. Let's start with tadalafil. The brand name is Cialis. We know tadalafil is approved for urinary symptoms in men with prostate enlargement. That's the official label. It doesn't shrink the prostate, it enhances urinary flow, and here's what I regularly observe in my patients. It reduces nighttime visits to the bathroom and urinary urgency, and it is very effective in doing it. But recent science suggests there might be more going on, including the other PDE5 inhibitors. Now we leave the solid ground of clinical practice and established guidelines. The lab is a place for new ideas that could turn into new concepts, so always bear that in mind. Animal data shows something remarkable. Sildenafil doesn't just dilate blood vessels, it can actually modulate nerve-muscle communication in the pelvic floor. For example, Anderson and colleagues reported in 2013 that sildenafil increased the activity of the external urethral sphincter in mice and also enhanced bladder nerve signaling. In plain English, the drug seemed to improve the way bladder and pelvic muscles coordinate. That's a different story than just more blood flow. It points to a possible neuromodulatory role. Clinically, this could explain why some men with pelvic floor overactivity or lower urinary tract symptoms report better function when using these drugs. Now, let's be clear. This is early science. We don't yet have large randomized clinical trials proving PDE5 inhibitors as a treatment for pelvic floor dysfunction. But it's a fascinating lead because if true, it would mean Viagra-type drugs could play a role not only in sexual medicine, but also in voiding disorders and pelvic health. Next, let's look at sleep. Obstructive sleep apnea is extremely common and strongly linked to erectile dysfunction. In fact, up to 65% of men with OSA also have ED, as shown in a study by Budweiser et al. Published in Respiration in 2009. So you might think, if these drugs improve blood vessels, maybe they could help sleep apnea too. Well, the answer is complicated. On the positive side, PDE5 inhibitors improve endothelial function and reduce inflammation. Both are relevant in sleep apnea. But on the negative side, there is also scientific data suggesting it might worsen the condition. That's a common problem in science. There's almost always controversy around a new concept. Hard to interpret even for experts and almost impossible for patients without guidance. In my clinical experience, I don't see negative effects on sleep apnea in my patients though. So the message is nuanced. These drugs interact with sleep physiology in ways we don't fully understand yet. And that's why any man with sleep apnea should talk to his doctor before using them. Finally, let's turn to metabolism. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease and type 2 diabetes are two of the fastest growing health problems worldwide. And both conditions are linked to erectile dysfunction. In animal studies, the data look very promising. For example, Shao et al., writing in Diabetes in 2011, showed that chronic sildenafil improved insulin sensitivity and reduced liver fat in a mouse model of obesity. That's powerful. In humans, though, the story is mixed. A randomized trial by Ho et al., published in Diabetes Care in 2014, found that sildenafil improved vascular function in men with diabetes, but didn't significantly change their blood sugar control. Other trials report similar findings. Vascular benefits, yes. Metabolic reversal, not really. That means don't expect these pills to normalize your blood sugar, but do expect them to help protect your vascular system if you live with diabetes. One thing is clear, the higher your HbA1c, the less likely these drugs are to work for erections. Poorly controlled diabetes makes ED harder to treat no matter what. So PDE5 inhibitors are not a fix for diabetes itself, but they may help protect vascular function in men living with it. So what's the big picture? PDE5 inhibitors are not cures for pelvic floor dysfunction, sleep apnea, or diabetes, but they touch common biological pathways, nitric oxide signaling, endothelial function, inflammation, that tie these conditions together. Think of it this way. When you treat ED, you may also be modulating systems that affect the bladder, the lungs, and even the liver. That's why this research is so exciting. But what is the difference between Cialis and Viagra, and which one is better? If this is something you've always wanted to know, you will have to watch this video. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched.